Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you to my channel Tech Talks. Today, I am going to talk about data structure and its introduction. For today's session, the contents are, first of all, I'll recall the concept of data structures. Then, I'll explain the types of data structures. I'll explain the examples of data structure, where they can be used, and the operations on the data structures. Objective of today's session are, at the end of this session, every learner will be able to understand data structures, its different types, with the help of different examples, where these data structures can be used, other way around, we can say that their applications, and which operations can be performed on it. Now let's start to recall data structures. A data structure is a specialized format for organizing and storing data. Mainly, it is used to store the data in organized format. General data structure types include array, the file, record, table, tree, and so on. We'll go through each and every data structure in this session. Any data structure is designed to organize data to suit a specific purpose so that it can be accessed and worked with in appropriate ways. Now let's start with the next slide, which explains types of data structures. Mainly, there are two types, primitive data structure and non-primitive data structure. Primitive data structures are integer, float, character, boolean, etc. Non-primitive data structures are further divided into two types, linear data structure and non-linear data structure. Here, I have explained the examples of all types of data structures. We'll go through them one by one. The first type of data structures are primitive data structures and non-primitive data structures. Name itself suggests that primitive data structures or types are predefined data types or a structure. All they are supported by all programming languages. The examples are integer, float, character, boolean, and so on. Non-primitive data structures are non-primitive data structures. They are not predefined in programming languages. As they are non-primitive, they are not predefined. The programmer has to define them. That's why the name is non-primitive data structures. They can be implemented with the help of primitive data types. Programmer has to implement them with the help of primitive data types. They are linear or non-linear in nature, and the examples are, for a linear data structure, arrays, linked lists, etc. For non-linear data structures, example are tree and graph. Now, what do you mean by linear data structure and non-linear data structure? So now let's start first of all with linear data structures. Linear data structures grows linearly. That's why the name is given linear data structure. Different operations which can be performed are in a linear way in linear data structures. Examples are, the first well-known example is array. As it grows linearly with the help of index of the array, the graphical representation of array is shown over here. For example, this is an array which is holding 7 elements and which is grown linearly from index 0 to index 6. Another example of linear data structure is linked list. Linked list is nothing but the collection of nodes. It also grows linearly. This is the example of linked list where 4 nodes are used, node 0, 1, 2 and 3 respectively, and it is holding some information into it. So the array and the linked list are the example of linear data structure, as both of them grows linearly. What do you mean by non-linear data structures? Obviously, as it is non-linear data structure, it does not grow linearly. So how it grows? They grows level wise. Here the examples are shown. The first example is tree, where the different nodes are shown over here at the different levels. And the graph, the connected nodes are there, again they are at a different level. We can't say these data structures can grow linearly because they are non-linear data structures, as they grow level wise. That's why these are the data structures which are non-linear data structures. The next type of data structure is based on the memory allocation or the memory utilization. The first one is sequential data structure. The data structure utilizes memory which is allotted sequentially are nothing but the sequential data structures. The memory allotted is sequentially in these type of data structures. The examples are arrays. That array may be a 1D array or a 2D array, or we can say it as a matrix or ND array. Array always allocates a memory sequentially. Character array is another example, which is also called as strings. Or if we are going to use the structures in our program, and array of that structure is another example of sequential data structure. All these are the types of arrays, and array always utilizes memory in sequence. That's why array is the best example of sequential data structures. Let's move forward for non-sequential data structures. As it does not utilizes memory in sequence, that's why they are non-sequential data structures. Memory allotted is scattered in the memory space. The example of non-sequential data structures are linked list, tree and graph. For these, the memory allotted is non-sequential. That's why they are non-sequential data structures. Now we'll see some examples of data structures. The first example is arrays. Many of the examples already we have seen previously. These are just list of the examples of the data structures. The first one is array, the matrix, or we can say that a 2D array, strings, or we can say that the character array, stack, next one is queue, linked list, tree, graph, tables, and at the end files. These are few of the examples of data structures. Which are the applications of data structures, or where the data structures can be used? Here few applications are mentioned. The first is, whenever we are going to call a function recursively, internally stack data structure is used. whenever we are going to use a printer in network, at that time the queue data structure is used. Usually we store the data. For that, the files data structure is used, and graph data structure is used to connect different cities. These are some of the examples, real-time examples, where the data structures are going to be used. To implement a data structure, we need to perform some operations on that. So, which operations we can be performed on the data structure? So, first of all, we need to create a data structure. After creation of data structure, we can insert elements in the data structure. As some of the elements are available in data structure, we can delete some of the elements from the data structure as far as the user's needs are concerned. Next, we can display the elements of data structure. If the set of data is available with our data structure, because basically data structures are nothing but the collection of organized data. So that's why with that data, if we want to search something in that, we can perform the same operation as well to perform search or to search an element from a data structure. Delete, we have already mentioned, and to modify the elements from the data structure. Modify or update, we can perform these operations also on the data structure. Now keep in mind, we can't perform all these operations on every data structure. They differ from one data structure to another data structure, but usually this is the list of all the operations that can be performed on the data structures. Thank you, dear friends, for listening this video.